Hello, and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Cardboard Coat Check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, what I'm hoping to do for you tonight is to give you an idea if you should be interested in the Night Cage. This is a creepy, dark game from Smirk and Laughter Games, Smirk and Dagger, I don't know which. It's got both symbols on here. They confuse me by having two different brandings. Maybe it falls under both because there'll be some hilarity happening in this game, but it's got a darker theme. This is cooperative, though, so there's no take that. There's no stabbing. So I think this fits better into Smirk and Laughter. Well, anyway, it doesn't matter. What does matter, though, is Smirk and Laughter, Smirk and Dagger, Kurt Covert actually gave me a copy of this at Origins and had me bring it home. So thank you for that, Kurt. I am really looking forward to checking this game out. This is a cooperative game for up to four players. Says 15-minute playtime. It's all about exploring an oubliette or a dungeon, and I got to get the shrink off this before I keep going because I'm reflecting like my whole room and like, hey, you can see my streaming setup. So right now, I'm going to cut the shrink off. Here you can see the rather creepy artwork on the Night Cage. I'm going to quickly show off this box, flip it around to the back for a bit, but then we're going to flip it down and show you what you get in the box. Here is my copy of the Night Cage. How long will your light last? This is a cooperative game for four players. I think it's up to four players. We'll find out. But it is a game that reminds me of a classic Games Workshop game called Dungeon Quest in a way. So not a lot to see here from what I understand, but we're going to show it off. So one of the cooler components in this game is your goal is to collect keys, find the keys in the oubliette. And the game comes with, I would say these are pewter metal keys, little actual metal keys. And speaking of games, is they're skeleton looking. They're skeleton keys. Very cool. They're actually cooler. I thought I am having a flashback here, a throwback here. Here's a deep cut for people my age. You'll get it. I am reminded of Waterworks. This game has nothing to do with Waterworks, but I am reminded of Waterworks. So there are four of these metal keys. Then we have the playing pieces here. We have the candle tracker, silicon pack. If you live somewhere very humid, keep that in your box. Otherwise, get rid of it. So you have the candles in different player colors. And I dig it because they're actually like all different heights. Yeah, they're all unique candles. I like that. They're all just a little different. I hadn't noticed that before. So that's a good visual update to the game. So it's not just the color that differentiates them, but the shapes. Then we get to the rule book. Now, this is a company that worked with Dice. I don't know if you've heard of Dice before, but it was a whole new system for learning games. There is a whole game tutorial in Dice. I have not checked that out. What I'm going to flip through here is the rule book. What I'm going to do to make that a little easier is I'm going to throw this on top so we can get this a little closer. We have the overview. And again, the dark, spooky theme is a big part of this game. I actually really wish I had gotten this opened up before Halloween. I think it would have been a good game for any of our Halloween game nights. So here's a look at the components that we're about to see them all. You are going to have to assemble this like card tile holder. And then there are individual materials for each of the characters. There's not a lot to see. Then we get to the setup continue, the two-page setup, and then how the game works. The big thing here is that your candle only illuminates the tiles that are next to you. You have to wander around in the board, try to find the keys, then gather up and go to a portal with everyone together. That's the overall gist of it. There's gate tiles you need to find. Then there's all the various monsters that are in the oubliette and how they work. And then we get into nerve, which is something that kind of gives you rerolls. It's a way to mitigate some of the randomness. I don't know what final flickers are. And then there is a full advanced game. So we're looking at 15 pages for the basic game. Might actually be 14 if we go past those components. And there is an advanced game. And then there is a whole way to adjust the difficulty, including like a funky thing that you can put out on the board before you start, which looked interesting. Again, this isn't meant to be a teach whatsoever. And then a turn progression on how you go through this. Play progresses clockwise to the next prisoner. Note you are prisoners in this oubliette. And then we have some black and white tiles, but we get a little bit of color first with the player cards. So each of these has two sides, one showing the standard, your lights lit, your candles lit, what you do on your turn. And the other side shows you if your lights out, what you do on your turn. And there is one of each of these in each of the five player colors. I do dig the subtle amount of color on there. That is a nice touch. Next, we have bonus baggies. to hold probably all the tiles. Appreciated. Some funky tiles. Oh, this is okay. So this is the discards, which discard. The discard for 5 prisoners or for 4 prisoners. And it's just a place to put the tiles as you're playing through. I do appreciate it gives you a spot. Then we get to tiles, and there's a lot. Look at this. Okay, it's not all tiles because we all set the board. So there is all the tiles. Not a lot to see here. Funky tiles with patterns on them. Those are all the same on that side. Those are pits. Once a pit crumbles, it flips to that side, I think it is. Or no, that's just the back. Sorry, that's just the back of the tiles. They all look the same. I don't know why some have babies or something. Various paths, symbols, funky stuff. This is that weird face that can be on the board. I have no idea what this creepy thing is. Maybe first player token. That's your courage. Was it courage? I can't remember now. Your one resource you can collect and spend. This is for building the candle tower. Your candles all run out, of course, when you run out of tiles. And then we have more tiles, including some crumbling tiles. These are the ones that on the back should show pits. So that's why the pits are on the back of all of them. So some of these are going to flip to the pit side. And more creepy, creepy tiles. What I'm going to try right here is how hard this is to punch. No, that was a joke. Okay. They punch super easy. Okay. No problem there. Then we get to the board. I don't know if this is going to fit on this camera or if I'm going to have to open things up. It's going to be close. There's not a lot to see. Except I shouldn't have done that. I should have sat back. So yes, we have the, it just says the night cage gives you a grid and it has the keys go in one spot. Nerve. That's the word I couldn't think of. Yeah. The board, there's two sides. There's this side for your standard 4-player game or less. This side for 5 players, just a bigger grid. Not a lot to see there. What I do dig is like I said, it's got the north, east, south, and there's somewhere to put the stuff, put the components. So we're going to toss the board in. We're going to toss all that cardboard in. No box insert whatsoever. Like I said, I think all the tiles are just going to go in here. I'm not sure what was in this. I'm going to toss that aside for now. That might have actually been from another game I unboxed. That's it. So you get in the night cage. Boom. That is the night cage from Smirk and Dagger Games. Same company, 2 different verticals, I guess. Not a lot of backstabbing in this one, though, because it's cooperative. You're a prisoner in an oubliette trying to escape. All you have to light your way is a single candle. If the candle burns out before you escape, you lose. Really impressed by the look. The aesthetic of this game is fantastic. The cover does a good job of showing off just how dark this is. It's a dungeon exploration cooperative game. Nice little metal keys that look like little skeleton heads, some tokens to track, and then player boards for everyone. And then a really nice candle holder to hold your tiles as you're playing. I am really looking forward to checking this one out. Plays 1 to 5 players. It says age 14 plus, but I can't see, except for the fact there's metal keys someone might swallow. It says 15-minute playtime. We'll find out when I actually try this game out. Really looking forward to playing The Night Cage. Now, when I do play The Night Cage, I will be sharing my thoughts on social media where I can be found everywhere as Tabletop Bellhop, one word. I'll be talking about it on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice as well as on YouTube if you prefer some video with your audio. And I will post up on tabletopbellhop.com. That's our webpage. And eventually I'll do up a full detailed review of this with a full overview of play and share our thoughts after we've gotten quite a few games in, because we like to play games quite a few times before we share our final thoughts, usually 5 times. So I am really looking forward to The Night Cage. This looks like a neat game. I like the components in here. Wish I had gotten this cracked open before Halloween. This would have been a great one for our public play events. But you know what? There's always Halloween next year, and we could always have a nightmare before Christmas. So thank you for joining me for this unboxing video. Good day and game on.